As promised, this is an entire video dedicated on the SI unit of amount, which is the mole. The mole is single-handedly the most important unit in chemistry. As you will learn today and explore deeper in future videos, the mole gives us an insight into the quantitative relationships between the amounts of reactants and products in a chemical reaction. And those relationships are fundamental to chemistry. I'll explain a bit later, but first, let's actually understand what a mole is, and we'll do that with an analogy. When you go to the store to buy eggs, they tend to come in a pack of 12. This is called a dozen. So when you buy 2 dozen eggs, you're actually buying 24 eggs. The egg farming industry likes to use dozens when they count their eggs. You can also go to the store and buy a pair of socks, which is made of 2 socks. So when counting socks, people like to use pairs to count them. Chemists like to do the same thing when counting the amount of a substance, except the number is a bit larger. In fact, it's much larger. Chemists like to use the number 6.022 times 10 to the 23. That is referred to as a mole. Why is it important to count chemicals in moles, and why is it such a massive number? There's no way we can actually count that many molecules with such precision, so why not use something simple like the mass? Well, that's because chemical reactions depict molar relationships of reactants and products. This is known as stoichiometry, and it's a really important term in chemistry. Stoichiometry is the ratio of substances you need to complete a reaction. Let's look at a simple example first. If you wanted to build a bicycle, you would need 2 wheels plus 1 body frame. So the ratio would be 2 wheels for 1 frame. What we care about to build the bicycle here is the count of our parts, not necessarily the mass. And the same principle applies in chemical reactions. So if we switched out the bicycle example and instead wrote the balanced chemical equation, 2 sodium plus 1 chlorine gas gives us 2 sodium chloride, we're actually implying that it requires 2 moles of sodium metal plus 1 mole of chlorine gas to make 2 moles of table salt. So the stoichiometry for these substances is 2 sodium for 1 chlorine gas for 2 sodium chloride. That's the molar ratio of substances we need to complete this reaction, just like how we built the bike. Another reason we don't use the mass is because 1 mole of sodium atoms does not have the same mass as 1 mole of chlorine atoms. Think about it, 1 dozen eggs and 1 dozen watermelons don't have the same mass, but they do count the same, and it's the count that matters in a chemical reaction. So 1 mole of 2 different elements don't actually have the same mass. The good thing though is that we can convert from mole to mass or vice versa, using the molar mass, which has units of grams per mole. On the periodic table, this number is found underneath each element. In our example, we can find sodium and chlorine, so let's grab those values and bring them back to our example. So if we had 1 mole of sodium metal, it would equal to 22.990 grams, but we have 2 moles here, so that's roughly 46 grams. 1 mole of chlorine atoms would equal to 35.45 grams, but we have to multiply this value by 2, since chlorine gas is actually a diatomic substance, just like oxygen is found in nature. So there's actually 2 atoms that form this molecule. So 1 mole of chlorine gas is roughly 71 grams. Now notice how the stoichiometry is 2 sodium for 1 chlorine gas, a ratio of 2 to 1. But that is not reflective at all when it comes to the mass values that we're seeing. So this actually shows us that the molar ratio and the mass ratio are 2 different things, and to never assume that they're the same thing. So always remember that the coefficient in a chemical reaction is the molar coefficient. Another thing that's worth noting is the sodium chloride. Since mass cannot be created or destroyed, we can actually determine that the final mass of the product will be the summation of our reactants. So the 2 moles of sodium chloride would have a mass of roughly 117 grams. Now let's actually take a look at why the molar mass of each element is different. If we draw out what each atom looks like, we can see that the atom has a different amount of protons, electrons, and neutrons. Now don't worry if you don't know what these things are, all of this is explained in topic 2. But for now, all you need to know is that this difference is what impacts the molar mass of the element. Now there's still one question we haven't answered, and it's why the mole is equal to such a large and non-simple value. When the SI system first introduced the mole in 1971 as a brand new base unit, its definition was the amount of atoms found in 12 grams of carbon-12, which is the most stable isotope of carbon. We'll cover isotopes in topic 2. That value was discovered to be 6.022 times 10 to the 23 in an experiment. And so that just kind of became the standard definition of what a mole is. In 2019, the SI system moved away from that experimental definition and instead just defined the number as exactly 6.0221406 times 10 to the 23. But you can still shorten it to 6.022 times 10 to the 23, and it will still give you a very precise answer. This number is also referred to as Avogadro's constant, in honor of the Italian physicist who paved the way for the discovery of the mole. Avogadro's constant allows you to count how many particles, or molecules, or atoms you have. For example, if you had 100 grams of pure liquid water, you could convert that to its molar amount by using the molar mass. Then you can convert that amount to how many water molecules you have using Avogadro's constant. Since we know that the chemical formula of water is H2O, that's one molecule of water has two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, meaning that we can actually figure out how many hydrogen and oxygen atoms are in our sample. This video should have given you a better understanding of the mole, which is an amount unit used by chemists. This unit is extremely important because it is at the core of being able to measure and communicate the amount of chemicals or substances in a chemical equation. The term stoichiometry is the molar relationship between chemical reactants and products, and the diagram on screen is a summary of how to convert to and from these different properties.